There are disruptive changes sweeping across the world because of the fourth industrial revolution and rapid technological advances. There are jobs that do not yet exist, and knowledge and skills that are not yet available in the curricula of many universities. We'll have to reimagine new models of learning and adjust the way we teach and learn.
This is phosphorus, this is carbon. You're going cold now.
Yes.
Professor Lo loves diamond and gold.
We build software, build solutions to actually help our customers be more efficient as well.
We aim to be a leading global university that inspires and innovates for positive societal impact.
身体觉得好吗？
As the national university, NUS intends to be at the forefront of this revolution, to nurture leaders of society working together in the spirit of innovation and enterprise. We will embed lifelong learning in the NUS DNA to ensure that we create knowledge and value for Singapore and Singaporeans.
Thank you.
graduation.
Distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, my heartiest congratulations to the graduating class of 2023. We are honored to celebrate this special occasion with you today. I applaud each and every one of you for doing remarkably well to reach this important milestone. Well done. Commencement signifies a major turning point in your life. You are going to embark on a new journey to become a responsible individual who can contribute and make a difference to both the corporate world and society. Over the past years, NUS Business School has nurtured and equipped you, hopefully with an entrepreneurial spirit, industry-relevant and soft skills to navigate a volatile future. Today, the world is facing unprecedented times of uncertainty. These arise from global issues like climate change and technological advancements like artificial intelligence. Businesses are racing to keep up with the rapid changes and to stay ahead of the competition. Amid these events, I'm confident you are ready to work and able to leverage the business school experience to ride out the challenges and thrive in every circumstance. I would also like to encourage you to have an insatiable appetite for knowledge and make continuous learning your lifelong goal. The world of work will continue to evolve. So will the skills that you need to succeed. Keep a pulse on the business landscape and see what may come next and the skills that you're going to require. Take advantage of the many postgraduate programs that the university and the school have to offer and consider upskilling yourself. That way you can constantly reinvent yourself and stay relevant. As you join our enormous university alumni network, take a moment, reflect on your achievements, and ask yourself, how can you build on the wide network to collaborate and create innovative solutions for the betterment of our businesses, our society, and our environment? As a business graduate, you're in a unique position to integrate different ideas and be a trailblazer. I look forward to your return to NUS Business School, and I encourage you to give back as an alum. Continue the legacy of your predecessors. Leading from Asia, NUS Business School is committed to nurturing the next generation of business leaders who are also going to be global citizens. You are an exemplar of our quality education. Now is your time to go out to the world and be a game changer. We are rooting for you. You are now our alumni and our pride. Our faculty, staff, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Thank you and good luck.
It gives me great pleasure to extend, on behalf of the faculty and staff of NUS Business School, our heartiest congratulations to you, your families, and loved ones on your graduation. You have successfully completed a very rigorous academic program and now graduate with a world-class MBA degree. Not too long ago, you entered NUS Business School with dreams, aspirations, and a hunger for knowledge. Today, you graduate with renewed passion and the skills, knowledge, and network that make you well-equipped to face new and bigger challenges with confidence. With the NUS MBA, you are ready to make a difference, have impact, and become a leader in your chosen field. Now that you will join our distinguished group of alumni, we hope you will reach out to our alumni from the other intakes and programs, and that you will nurture this community. Do stay in touch and do remain a strong member of our vibrant community. We always love to see you. Congratulations once again. We look forward to hearing about your achievements in the years to come, wishing you all the very best.
Enjoy your life. 享受生活。
Congratulations, everybody. Keep exploring about the world and, more importantly, about yourself. You're full of possibilities. We're all so excited for you. Congrats.
Spread joy, spread laughter, spread sheets, all the best, ChatGPT. Yeah.
Are you ready for graduation?
No.
Is the working world ready for me?
Hi guys, I'm MJ from Just Keep Thinking.
And I'm Fauzi from TSL. We're here in campus to ask students what they think about their life after graduation.
In the future, I want to go into ESG and go into the finance sector.
Actually, I have nothing like fully planned out yet. I just graduated and I'm like new to this adulting and working world. So I'm just gonna go with the flow and see how it goes.
We study a lot of like electrical stuff, okay, but we are not like aircon repairmen, as what many people say. I'm going on as a network engineer. Perhaps after that, I might want to upskill myself, take on a master's.
Do you know there's a NUS lifelong learning program available?
I've seen a website before, but I'm not really sure what is that about.
You can take courses and upgrade your skills to stay relevant and competitive in the workforce.
NUS alumni get e-vouchers, which you can use to redeem one full fee module. I'm going to sign up for a course now.
Wait. You can just sign up using your phone.
Okay,
go all the way there. Come, let's do it together.
Oh.
Scale.nus.edu.sg.
Wow.
Today is special. I've spent my whole life preparing for this. But it isn't just about me. It's for a special someone.
For me, okay?
Who has made sacrifices for my aspirations and my dreams? Today, I remember how I got here and who made it all possible.
The biopsy results have revealed that you have stage 4 breast cancer. I'm sorry.
Today is special. For the people who never gave up on me. The people who made me believe that tomorrow will always be better. Ma, you did it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dear class of 2023, my congratulations to each of you. Today, we celebrate your achievements and the moments that have led you here, where you push yourselves to learn and grow, emerging stronger, wiser, and ready to take on the world. You are channeling main character energy today. But the one thing that all main characters face are character-defining moments. As you step into society, you will encounter many such moments where you find yourself between a rock and a hard place, where right and wrong isn't so clear-cut, and complexities abound. In such times, we hope you will rely not just on the skills and knowledge you have gained here, but also on the values that we hold dear: integrity, respect, innovation, excellence, and resilience. The path ahead is yours for the picking, wherever it may lead. NUS is committed to being your lifelong learning partner to help broaden, deepen, and diversify your skills and equip you to seize new opportunities amid fast-evolving times. We welcome you to the NUS alumni family and hope you will stay connected to this vibrant community that continues to make waves in every field of society. Class of 2023, congratulations on a job well done and a momentous milestone achieved. I wish you all the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony is about to begin. Please turn off your mobile phones or switch them to silent mode. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
I declare this ceremony for the presentation of graduates in the School of Business. Please be seated. Open.
It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Ong King Pong, the guest speaker of this ceremony. Mr. Ong is a regional CEO of Southeast Asia at PSA International. He's on the Senior Management Council and has overall responsibility for the group's portfolio of operating terminals, investment, and expansion in Southeast Asia, including PSA's flagship terminal in Singapore. He's actively involved in the maritime and technology space and is chairman of the Center for Maritime Study Management Board, as well as chairman of Crimson Logic. He is also a member of the Urban Redevelopment Authority Board and NUS Business School Management Advisory Board, holding MBA from the National University of Singapore. He will now deliver his speech.
Ms. Jeanette Wong, NUS trustee, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all of you. First and foremost, I'd like to thank the NUS Business School for the privilege of being part of this commencement ceremony. As we commemorate this milestone together, I'm deeply honored to be here today to share personal insights and reflections that I hope will resonate with each of you. I am an NUS Business School alumnus. I graduated with my BBA in 1990 and then my MBA in 1996. In fact, I met my wife here. She's an alumnus here as well. And with divine coincidence, my son also graduated with the same degree, and he too met his wife here, but probably we passed on as it was during the COVID years. Graduating with this NUS MBA, I was eager to take on the world, fueled by a kaleidoscope of dreams. This degree that you have earned is not just a testament to your academic accomplishments. It is a symbol of your potential to shape the future. Equipped with an arsenal of skills, knowledge, and influence, you possess the ability and will the power to profile the trajectory of businesses, industries, and communities. However, with great power comes great responsibility. All of us here have that responsibility to be diligent stewards. And so, my first insight is on being a steward leader. The concept of stewardship was first imparted to me by Professor Hui Taki, who has since retired. He taught me statistics back in the 90s. He said that while most things in life have a probability curve, there are only two certainties, two polar extremes that we will all encounter. Any guesses? Yes, that we are born and we will die. Everything else, everything in between is relative and uncertain. These two bookends frame our existence, reminding us of the finite nature of our time. With this context, stewardship is then the profound understanding that we are not mere owners of resources and opportunities that come our way. Rather, we are custodians entrusted with their care and preservation for future generations. In recognizing this, you will realize that true success is not solely defined by financial gains or accolades. Rather, it is the impact you made on the world and the lives of others that counts. Hence, this awareness fuel your sense of purpose, urgency, and determination as you seize opportunity that matter. Let your actions be driven by a vision that extends far beyond personal gain, beyond fleeting accolades, and towards impact that truly transcends generation. The next reflection is on kindness. Be a kind leader. This is often a quality that is underestimated and perceived as a sign of weakness. I, however, see it as a sign of strength. It takes courage to be kind, especially in the face of adversity, competition. Kindness is not just about being nice. It is about empathy, compassion, and treating others with respect and dignity. And choosing to do so requires mindfulness and consistent effort, not always the easiest to do. But when you lead with kindness, you inspire loyalty, trust, and collaboration. Kindness goes beyond being a moral imperative. It is a strategic advantage that fosters heightened employee engagement and cultivates customer loyalty, which in turn drives sustainable growth. Kindness builds bridges and it breaks down barriers. It creates a ripple effect of positive change. Now, more than ever, the world needs kind leaders. You can become a beacon of hope, inspiration, and ethical leadership in a world that often seems chaotic and divided. The final reflection is on humility, a humble leader. True humility, it is not about belittling yourself or shying away from your accomplishments. It is about acknowledging your abilities while appreciating the contributions and expertise of others. It stems from recognizing that you are part of something greater than yourself, that your success is intertwined with the efforts of others. Earlier, I shared with you about my family of NUS Business School alumni. It is a testament to the power of shared experiences, not to mention the impact this school has had on our lives. As you embark on your own journeys, I encourage you to continue fostering the relationship and friendships that you have forged here. So look around, yes. Look to your left, look to your right. Surround yourself with a dependable circle, individuals that you can trust and whose expertise surpasses your own. Surround yourself with those who complement your strengths, challenge your perspectives. Avoid the trap of surrounding yourself with mere yes men and women. Avoid the echo chamber of constant agreement. I have this practice of having breakfast with my band of senior colleagues in the office once a month. We call ourselves the ABC group. With no fixed agenda, together we confront elephants in the room, including little nuances, and keep each other grounded with a metaphorical mirror that reveals our own shortcomings. Humility is often marked by a genuine desire to learn from others. Listen actively, and you'll be surprised by the depth of insights that unfold. As I close, I'm reminded that this is indeed apt for today's ceremony to be called a commencement. This commencement represents the dawn of new beginnings. Congratulations to each and every one of you on this remarkable achievement and milestone. As you embark on a new chapter, may your journey be an exciting and extraordinary one, illuminated by the brilliance of your dreams. Thank you.
Madam Presiding Officer, may I present graduates on whom the following degree have earlier been conferred. Doctor of Philosophy, Chen Danyang. Lin Zhe. Zhang Keyuan. Zori Ting. Chen Li. He Juan. Sun Hai Long. Sun Qing He. Master of Business Administration, the NUS Executive MBA. In Chinese, Jing Xiaowei, winner of the C. Lionor Medal and Prize. Liu Weisheng, winner of the CHV Medal and Prize. Zhi Wei, winner of the Chiu An Mei Yu Academic Excellence Award. Bai Jing. Bai Li Feng. Bi Hai Yu. Chen Fu Qiang. Chen Jian. Chen Xiang. Zhou Minsheng. Cui Jingshuang. Dou Sha Sha. Du Jun. Fan Xichao. Fu Mao Qing. Fu Xin. Gao Sheng. Gao Xinhua. 贵志。郭旭帝。何金凯。许碧兰。金海莲。李菁。李茂宏。李敏。李伟。李祥敏。李振宇。卢菲亚。陆建礼。陆勇。罗丹。马建新。倪耀亮。Patchy Kang。 任文涛。沈清叶。史达展。王林。 Wang Yingying. Wang Xiuhua. Wang Xuedong. Wang Zhe. Wei Zhiming. Wu Chen. Xiang Jing. Xiao Liangrong. Xie Zehao. Xu Tianshuai. Xu Wenjun. Yang Qingfu. Yang Qing. Yang Zhengguo. Yuan Shangwen. Yuan Xingwei. Zhang Hongmei. Zhang Jilei. Zheng Zhong. Zhong Boan. Zhuang Yan.
Madam Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have earlier been conferred. Master of Business Administration, the NUS Executive MBA. Aditya Vivek Jalisadki. Ali Mohammed Hashem M. Al-Khatib. Andrew James Nibb. Anthony Stanislaus. Antoine Marie Pascal Armel Gaspar de Montemurion. Arun Kumar. Ayumi Mizutani. Brian Kiao Tet O. Chen Lan. Dai Da. Daniel Tan Danyi. Dennis Ming Yung Lai. Dave Akbar. Fahad Khan. Fong Hyo Lon. Ho Shin Hui. Rishikesh Deepak Gore. Jasmine Elisa Cheng Xiang Yi. Jeffrey Lee Phuc Wei. Gemma Alexandra Lamkin. Joshi Anurag Vijay Kumar, Lakshmi Narayan Sasidharan, Lee Kui Gek, Leong Ho Wai, Lena Marikan Nguyen, Ma Xiaoyun, Manjesh Basavaraja, Nam Ba Fong, Pietro Curto, Rahul Vijayan, Rochit Das, Sharmili Roy, Shin Tae Young, Subramaniam Kasi, Sudhakar Kumar, Sun Jong Hao, Tai Sing An, Teo Yet Feng Francis, Tisha Lin Sinatambu, Vincent Na Gyeong Wing, Wu Chi Ming, Xia Jie, Xie Qian, Yip Hei Tung. NUS, University of California, Los Angeles, double degree program, Master of Business Administration. Winner of the CHV Medal and Prize, Dawar Shah Akhtar. Andrew Tian Chang. Ayumi Sano. Bessie Chu. Christy Ha Dang. David Tan Sien Yung. Desmond Mao Ren Hao. Dmitry Filipov. Huang Pin Loon. Huang Ting Yi. Khan Guk Lee. Kartigayan Parvati Chela Perumal. Kim Won Ki. Ko Sing Liang. Liu Lei. Melody Putri Budiono. Natasha Dion Humphreys. Nurul Jehan Ali Gan. Omar Kenyatta Higgs. Owen James Kersey O'Connor Awoki. Prasanna Annamalai. Ryan William Nelson. Shunsuke Sato. Srinivas Avihana Thrillapati. Stephen C. Huang. Varun Maheshwari. Vincent Martin Tangkilisan. William Ying Ki Huang. Xiao Hao Yu.
Ma'am Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have earlier been conferred. NUS HEC Double Degree Program, Master of Business Administration. Alexandra Yi Lun Li. Gerard Thierry Nemkam. NUS Yale University Double Degree Program, Master of Business Administration. Chun Ting Wu. Jiazi Duan. Master of Business Administration. Lee Tengsir Raymond. Winner of the Reginald Quaj Memorial Medal. Winner of the Ernst & Young Prize, Akshay Singhal. Winner of the Marketing Institute of Singapore Prize, Amit Jain. Winner of the Panasonic Prize, Nikhil Mittal. Winner of the Inchcape Berhad Prize, Spencer Alexander Olof Osterjenk. Ashika Teresa Saju. Ayush. Abhinav Bountiyal. Adil Raza Zaidi. Aditi Kapoor. Aditya Saharia. Aditya Thimaya Bhatt. Aiko Furukawa. Alphonse Chen Yanrong. Alvin Kwon Jin Tae. Amit Samdarshi. Ang Yi Jia. Ankit Kumar. Ankita Kumari. Anmol Sinha. Anshul Rajput. Anu James. Aswin Kumar Rajappa. Avik Sarkar. Ela Francesca Tablante Reyes. Azad Singh. Benjamin To Kwan Yu. Chao Shi. Castaneda Gabriel Ma Tresiana. Chan Chi Kyong. Chan Yishung Joel. Chen Yiting. Chu Wenqing, Royston. Chi Ching Sien. Ching Turk Zi. Cho Shi Sun. Christopher Gary. Daegon Kim. Daniel John Burns. Daniel Ong Shao Kiang. Daniela Colazzo Zarate. Deepika Raina. Deng Yiting. Dong Li Shi. Dong Qian. Yom Jun Yong. Fadli Zil Ikram Adesta. Fan Hui. Fan Yang. Francesca Katrina Tankiang. Freda Tan Yichui. Fu Lin. Gokul Raghunath Prabhu. Gregory Ranjan George. Gweta Launel Bahai. Guo Wei. Guo Chen. Gwendolyn Ong Wei Ling. Han Danyang. Han Jinglin. Hashim Fazal Hasnain. Heng Kang Kai. Himanshu Kaul. Hitoshi Takahashi. Xia Yu Wan. Hu Wenlong. Yeo Suk Yong. Justin Marco Anson Nograles. Kanda Vanish Tanarak. Kazuki Masuda. Kaisuke Fujitomi. Komisetti Venkat Rama Subramanyam. Kor Zi Yuan Joseph. Kwan Ying Seng. Kwok Wai Wong. Lau Su Lin, Sarah. Lauren Korpotox. Li Wei Wei, Sherlina. Leo Bunin. Leong Soo Min, Bernice. Li Xiaobin. Lily Dai. Lim Wei Siang. Lin Jun Yu. Lina Ichiki. Lin Lu Chao. Liu Hong Yu Yi. Liu Jiahang. Liu Chi. Liu Yongchu. Lu Changji. Lu Chen. Lu Jiaxin. Lu Shijun. Mark Venkit Melvin. Manoj Anand. Mao Wu Yang. Masahiko Hongo. Mikhail Namo. Mikito Maruno. Mithun Gunsekar Dandapani. Mohammad Ashraf. Mohammad Ali Adil Malik. Mohammad Ali Burney. Mohammad Hadi Ansari. Muskan Harlalka. Nam Arnman. Neha Singh. Neil Kishore Nevgi. Neo Cheng B. Iris. Neo Se Han, Aaron. Ang Hui Xuan, Joyce. Nguyen Kin Angok. Nikhil Garg. Nishant. Noor Amira Binte Sadiran. Ong Tien Sheng, Royston. Parthasarthi Vemulamada. Paritosh Tripathi. Parth Srivastava. Piyali Gupta. Pongdao Premrote. Radhika Gupta. Ramnik Narayan. Remy Tran. Ren Jingyao. Sang Hun Han. Sanjana Manku. Sari Luka. Satya Karunagaran. Serene Wong. Shaurya Thapar. Shilpa Singh. Shivam Misra. Shota Kawabata. Shreyas Likhite. Sit Wing Tim Jonathan. Steve Praviro Maruto. Swa Joni. Suma Hebale. Sun Cheng. Sung Han Kim. Surya Shruti Nadiminti. Takayuki Yamamoto. Takichiro Gondokusumo. Tanviva. Tan Liang Sheng. Tang So Yu. Tang Chong Siu. Tatsuaki Seto. T. Meng Chin Anthony. Teng Yun Ting. Tiong Kai Ling. Tomoyuki Takuchi. Toru Isono. Udit Devan. Udit Narayan Chakravarti. Varun Gupta. Venkat Sai Prajwal Savanam. Vincent Go Chi Seng. Vincent Matthias Chan Sai Leng. Vinod John Paul Mendu Chechen. Vipin Pal Singh. Vipul Jain. Vishal Taneja. Wong Bo. Wong Wiru. Wong Yu. Wong Jinye Daniel. Wu Jiahao. Si Ling Ling. Xin Yu Chao. Xin Yu Wong. Shu Lu Ping. Shu Sin Yi. Yi Shu. Yimiao Lu. Yip Yu Kyong. Yu Min San. Young Jin Sun. Yuhan Ma. Yu Chiao Chiao. Yutaka Oba. Cha Jun Kyo. Chang Anan. Chang Jiaju. Chang Wanlu. Chao Bin. Chu Xiaoyan. Chu Chenfei. Chuo Wei.
The valedictorian for this ceremony is Mr. Liu Weisheng, who graduated with a degree of Master of Business Administration, the NUS Executive MBA Chinese program. Weisheng is a winner of the CHV Medal and Prize. Tapping on his professional expertise, Weisheng initiated and chaired the English Club in 2022 in the Chinese EMBA community. He organized a series of hybrid or face-to-face sharing sessions to help members improve their English in a business context, benefiting more than 70 students and alumni. Weisheng will now deliver his speech.
Good morning, Ms. Jeanette Wong, NUS Trustee, Mr. Ong Kim Pong, Regional Chief Executive, Southeast Asia, PSA International, Dean Professor Andy Rose, distinguished guests, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I am Liu Weisheng, a student from NUS EMBA Chinese Intake 30. I am proud and humbled to represent the outstanding graduates. Time flies, and I can hardly believe that I'm already graduating from NUS. I'm honored to be an EMBA student at the Asia's number one university. I have studied at the Chang Kuang Graduate School of Business and the Wharton School, but I have never experienced the level of rigor I found at NUS. I will start getting jitters from half a month before the start of each session until half a month after the classes, because of pre and post assignments of the workload. My classmates can take detailed notes verbatim while managing their work during class and share the notes immediately after the session. Some students invite renowned economists to deliver lectures on finance before the course begins, providing thorough preparation. Some students improve our already good enough dining experience by bringing delicacies like meat buns and steel noodles, causing each of us to gain 3 pounds at the end of each session. If you don't see the world, how can you develop a worldview? NUS brought us to top universities like Cambridge and Stanford, and provided us with professors and company visits at the pinnacle of their fields, allowing us to witness the highest level of excellence. At Cambridge, we glimpsed into the past. At Stanford, we saw the future. We may not remember the exact content of the lectures years later, but the experience of studying and living at the world's top universities will be unforgettable for a lifetime. Besides studying and traveling, I also love the people here. NUS not only gives us knowledge, but also transforms our social network. I am delighted to discover that a group of talented individuals who, despite having their own success, still dedicate so much time to the friendships they formed here. Some of us spontaneously organize study groups, company visits, and trips to Indonesia, Japan, and Maldives. Some led groups in playing soccer or pursuing weight loss. I am fortunate to be able to teach English to more than 70 fellow students for 4 sessions. 100% of them have reported an improvement in their spoken English. I'm so delighted to integrate into Singaporean society in this way. We have also received invaluable guidance from our mentors. The professors at NUS are exceptionally outstanding. Professor Fu Qiang has a comprehensive understanding of the Eastern and Western worlds. Some students successfully sold their stocks before the interest rate hike in the US because they took Professor Fu's macroeconomics class. Professor Wu Yaozhong not only brings immense inspiration and impact to students in class, but also engages in running and fitness activities with us outside of the class. Each professor has their unique qualities and deserves our admiration. Whenever we encounter issues in our lives or work, we can seek advice from them in various fields. At this moment of celebration, we must express our gratitude to our families for their unconditional support. Working and studying might reduce our family time, so it would be impossible without their support. We also want to thank the admission team for strictly maintaining admission standards, which resulted in a high-quality circle of students. We're also grateful to the program management team for seamlessly connecting every aspect of the curriculum and logistics. After the study tour at Stanford, I embarked on a road trip in the United States. Every time I drove into a gas station along the way, I felt relieved and recharged. The car had fuel, and my heart was at ease. NUS is like the most important gas station on our journey of life. We drive our own cars, enter this gas station, taking energy and courage, and then continue towards even greater goals. After graduation, some classmates may be promoted or change their careers. Others may start new businesses or expand their companies to the whole world. Whatever path each of you choose, I wish you all the best in utilizing what you have learned here. May the university thrive. May the teachers and students achieve greater success in their endeavors. And may our families enjoy good health and peace. Thank you.
Dear graduates, as we come to the end of today's ceremony, we would like to extend our heartiest congratulations to you on your commencement. We warmly welcome you to the NUS alumni family.
I declare this ceremony closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem.
As we remain standing, my fellow graduates, this is a proud day for all of us and for our parents and loved ones who have supported us in our journey here. Therefore, before we leave this auditorium, let us take this opportunity to show our appreciation for our family and friends with a round of applause. Please join me in this gesture.
Congratulations, class of 2023.